Hi, this is Lisa, the teen librarian with the Greenville County Library System. Welcome to our celebration for April's Poetry Month, Virtual Blackout Poetry. Now, I was lucky enough to find a really cool web tool so that you can do blackout poetry at home on your own computer. Normally, when we do blackout poetry, you get a sheet of a damaged book, just a page, and you read the words and choose which words you want to keep, and then using a black marker, you black out everything else, and you end up creating a really cool poem. Now, the great thing about blackout poetry is, much like my friend William Carlos Williams, there is a beauty in the poetry of fairly short poems. So the red wheelbarrow, so much depends upon a red wheelbarrow glazed with rainwater beside the white chickens. It's only a few words, but there's a very clear image that's created. It's really beautiful. So it's really fun to do blackout poetry because you really are limited by the words that you're given, and then you get to create something really new from it. So with this, and the link below, there is in the description a link to this tool. And it is a glitch that was created by this lovely girl, Emma Winston, and it's a real easy way to create your own blackout poetry online. So she has here three different sample texts: Alice in Wonderland, Pride and Prejudice, Heart of Darkness, all works of fiction that are in public domain, so she can use them. And so you could use any of these three different ones, but the really nice thing is she also allows for you to type in anything else you want. So I typed in a page from from Wizard of Oz, and so I just pasted it in and I hit enter text, and that's my work that I want to work with. And the fun thing is you can change it up in here. So I can go to font, and there are all these different fonts, and I can choose any of them. So there's different ones. They just look a little bit different. I personally like that one. And you can also make it so that the text is bigger or smaller depending on how you want it to work. So that's what I'm going to work with. So to create your blackout poetry, instead of using a black marker, you just come up here and choose and click on the words that you want to keep. So I'm going to keep Dorothy, shining, and standing patiently, must want bread. Now, if I don't like them, the words I choose, I can just click on it again and it goes away. Or if I don't like any of them, I can just go right down here and reset, and it all starts again. So I'm changing it this time. Dorothy shining through. She patiently must sleep. So I've chosen the words I want, and then I'm going to come down here and I hit blackout, and I only have those words left. So if you reset now, it just restarts again, and you just go back and click through what you want. I'm just showing this blackout. Now then you can come down here and render it either as a full square or just the text that you want, which is a little bit shorter. And then if you want to save it, depending on what you're doing this on, here I'm going to left click on my mouse And I can just save my image that way or copy my image. So it's really fun because you can create all different kinds of things because you can use the text that she has or enter in any of your favorite books, any page, any text that you want and create something new with it. I hope you enjoy making poetry through this fun web tool.